If you're looking to never ever heal your eczema or psoriasis, do the things I mentioned in this video and you'll have great success not having any success with healing your skin. What's up my friends? Welcome to another video. I'm Rob Stewart. I'm here to help you get your skin and your overall health back on track. You guys guessed it from the intro. Today I'm going to be talking about why you are not having any success healing eczema, dermatitis, and psoriasis, and what things will never allow you to heal your skin if you keep doing them consistently. Now, this video is not about shaming anybody because I've done all of these things and I did all of these things for years. I failed for years trying to heal my own skin. And so I've learned from my mistakes and I've learned from the 1500 plus people that I've worked with, helping them heal their skin with the mistakes that they've made. So again, this video is not about making you feel bad or making you feel guilty or making you feel shameful. It's sharing with you guys the path that held me back from not healing my skin. And for those of you who don't know me or you're new to this channel, I've been eczema, dermatitis, and psoriasis free for 9+ years, which is an awesome accomplishment. I'm super stoked. And what I mean by healed, because I do think the eczema community and the psoriasis community has this a little bit backwards. And I do blame a lot of the people who are on Instagram and YouTube, influencers within our community for perpetuating this myth. So here's the myth. What I mean by cured and healed is I don't have flare-ups. I don't have skin disease anymore. I don't have any of the symptoms or things that I dealt with for my entire life leading up to 9 years ago. When I run across people's content who say that they've healed their skin, but then they also still have flare-ups and they also still have the skin disease, I don't think we're talking about the same thing. And I would go so far as to say that a lot of the advice that those people give is about dealing with symptoms, which is the opposite of being cured. Healing skin disease is not about managing your symptoms. Healing skin disease is about being healthy and freeing yourself from having to deal with flare-ups and symptoms altogether. So that's what I mean by healing your skin, and that's the level of healing that I'm trying to teach and that I'm promoting. Fully healed, cured, no symptoms, no flare-ups, normal, healthy skin for life. So here's how to never, ever heal your skin completely. Number one, you're not customizing your diet. And this is by far the most important aspect of fully healing your skin, having no flare-ups and no symptoms, is you do have to take the time to work yourself through food groups and macros and calorie ranges to customize your entire diet so that you can sustain it for life long term and know exactly what foods to eat, what foods are neutral, and what foods to avoid. Once you've customized your diet, the whole healing process becomes so much easier and just becomes about being consistent day to day with these things long term. The approach that you see all the time, and I'm rolling my eyes because I fell hook, line, and sinker for this so many times throughout the healing process. I mean, I struggled trying to naturally heal my skin for like 8 years. I couldn't figure it out. And one of the biggest mistakes I was doing was buying somebody's book or seeing someone else and trying to copy their diet. Also, when I was trying to do this 10, 15 years ago, there was no YouTube information and Instagram people helping anybody. It's like I said in earlier the video, it is both positive and negative. You have a lot of information, but 99% of it is absolute crap and does not really lead to healing long term. So something that I fell for a very long time was, if you just go raw vegan and eat the same way I do, you're gonna cure everything. And absolutely BS on that. If someone's promoting an eczema or psoriasis healing diet and they're promoting the exact same diet for everyone, like Medical Medium does, like Dr. Morris does, like a whole bunch of them do, like John Rose does, the same diet will not heal everybody. And a diet based on just sugars and just fruit and just juicing is generally pretty horrible. Number two, you're not consistent. Super boring advice, but it's about as honest as it gets. The reason why I've stayed eczema, dermatitis, psoriasis free for as long as I have is because I've been 100% consistent. Now that doesn't mean that I never have a cheat meal or don't have any fun things to eat here and there, because I absolutely do. But I've earned that over a long period of time because I know where my wiggle room is because I've customized my diet. Once you customize your diet, like I said, it makes it so much easier because I know that I can have these delicious foods and they're still good for me, or at worst, neutral. And if I just avoid these gnarly trigger foods and stay consistent with these ones, I'll be good to go for the rest of my life. Something that will hold you back, and I'm just being absolutely straight up. And here's where, you know, a lot of people will disagree with me, but I know the content creators out there, and the intro was for you guys, the people who are promoting a vegan diet and a raw vegan diet, yet you're still having flare-ups, yet your skin has never been fully cured, and you're giving advice as if the vegan diet and the plant-based diet is perfect for everybody and going to just do the job. You just gotta be vegan long-term. You guys are not healed and you're not cured. And so therefore your diet is not working. Don't fall for BS content creators' propaganda for you to buy their crappy products and their crappy services. Healing skin disease is not about managing your symptoms. That's what sick people do. Healing skin disease is about being healthy and freeing yourself from having to deal with flare-ups and symptoms altogether. Number four, here's another big mistake, is you focus only on diet. Now, I realize I've talked about only diet so far because diet is a very important thing, but there are other aspects to healing your skin. Doing the gentle level of cleansing and detoxification, managing stress, hacking your circadian rhythm so you get enough sleep and recuperation each and every single day. People that you have surrounding you, even your career and the things that you do on a day-to-day basis, will affect your hormones and your stress levels and your digestion, and therefore affect your skin. Gotta be consistent with your diet. You gotta have a customized diet approach, but in the end, you also have to be a well-rounded, happy, healthy individual. Number five, here's something that I struggled with. Man, so hard. This was really hard for me. And I will be totally honest with you, even the people who say they're not obsessed with this, after I talk to them, they are obsessed with it. So you have an unrealistic timeline and expectation for healing. There was a comment on one of my videos the other day saying, Rob, I've been doing, trying to customize my diet, and I've been doing everything that you say for 2 weeks now, and my skin hasn't healed yet. And it's like, you're off to a great start, but it takes about a year for the skin to fully heal. And if you're over consumed with how fast it's gonna happen, you're gonna give up. Remember, it's a marathon, not a sprint. To customize your diet takes time. To gently cleanse and detox your body and get your hormones back on track takes a lot of time. And to figure out exactly what you need to do with your lifestyle in order to allow the other two things to work takes time. The body doesn't heal overnight. Again, this kind of goes back again to my earlier points. When you see people saying, heal your gut in 30 days or heal your skin in 60 days or do this cleanse in 2 weeks, your skin will be healed. It's like, that's absolute rubbish, absolute crap. And that's holding you back when you have that mindset. Number six does relate to number five. Again, this is part of the vegan trap, is that over cleansing and staying on detox protocols, like really long juice cleanses or a fruit only diet for too long, is absolutely counterproductive. You have to nourish yourself with your customized diet in order to turn over healthy skin. So one of the biggest pet peeves of mine is when I talk to, God, I didn't want to say it, but I'll just say it. I was talking to an Ayurvedic practitioner and we got into a pretty good debate and an argument. And this is a person who helps people heal their skin, yet still has skin disease, still has eczema, still has flare-ups, yet she tries to teach people, other people, how to not have, I don't get it. Anyway, she has an Ayurvedic background, and her main thing with pretty much all of her clients, and this is how I came to talk to her, is one of her old clients came to me for help, and we were able to have good success pretty quickly, actually. And she said, I would love it if you talk to my Ayurvedic practitioner because all she ever told me was, you haven't cleansed and detoxed enough. You have to detox more. You have to cleanse more. Oh, you're not having results because you're cleansing and detoxing still. Oh, you just haven't cleansed enough. Look, people, cleansing and detoxification is actually a lot simpler than people make it out to be. And it doesn't take 6 months and it doesn't take a year to cleanse and detox your system. When you over cleanse and when you detox too much, it leads to things like bad hormones, unhealthy body weight, food obsession, and the fact that your mind will not have the nutrients that it needs to actually think. Your body won't have the actual nutrients it needs to be healthy. Cleansing and detoxification is part of healing your skin, for sure. But what I've noticed is that you got to do it in a very gentle, methodical way. And as much or more than you cleanse, you have to re-nourish your body with the right nutrients after a cleanse and after detoxification practices. If you're just hitting the cleansing and detoxification all the time, you will end up with low testosterone, low GH, a horrible body shape and body form. You will not be a healthy, supple, robust body weight and body fat for yourself. You will have inflammation and you will stress your body out way more than you need to. Last but not least, the thing holding most people back, and this one's more nuanced and a little bit more confusing, and so this one's an easy one to mess up on. It will take a little bit of work, but once you get this one, the freedom is huge that it can produce. In the early phases, I'm sure you've heard this before, is a lot of times the skin will get worse before it gets better. And as people are trying to figure out their customized diet, they look at the wrong things to see if they're making progress or not. And this is again why so much of the content that I see out there is just, it doesn't work for people, because they're looking only at symptomatic response. So, okay, if I eat these foods and a few days later my skin's not that great, then I shouldn't eat these foods. Guess what? Every food you eat for a long time is gonna have a response of your skin flaring up. Your skin's flaring up because it's an autonomic nervous system inflammatory response. Your autoimmune system is fighting itself. Whether you're eating the right foods or not, that pathology is the last thing to heal. You gotta heal your gut biome. The gut biome leads to the filtration system. The filtration system leads to your hormonal system. Your hormonal system leads to your immune system. Your immune system leads to your autoimmune system. Your autoimmune system leads to your autonomic nervous system inflammatory response. Then the skin heals. So you have to heal those systems systematically before the skin's actually gonna show really awesome results. Again, that's why it takes about a year for most people. The thing you look for is not your skin. The skin will lie to you. The skin will confuse you. How many people come to me on a weekly basis and they say, well, I did that diet for 2 weeks, but nothing happened with my symptoms, and so I gave up. That is the problem. You didn't get any real data. You didn't stick with something long enough to be able to go, okay, here's the data, and now here's the refinement and the new direction that I have to go, small adjustments. The whole system of doing that is based on your biofeedback and your biomarkers. Again, this isn't the video to get into that, because I could do 100 videos just on biofeedback and biomarkers, and I already have done several videos. So reading your biomarkers and not your skin symptoms is the ultimate key to knowing if you're on the right track or not. And it's the ultimate key to knowing how and when to adjust your diet. Because most likely, if you're doing this for the rest of your life, there's gonna be times when your biomarkers, your environment, and things shift, and you will have to adjust. Remember, my friends, don't beat yourself up if you're doing all of these things, because I did all of these mistakes all the time. You can learn from your mistakes, but you don't have to. You can learn from my mistakes and start the process of naturally healing your skin today. Use this as a checklist and be honest with yourself. And if you're doing a few or all of these things, or even just one of these things, you're really holding yourself back, and now you know what you need to do to overcome those mistakes and get your skin and overall health on the right track. That's gonna do it for me today, guys. Thanks so much for watching the video. For those of you who need some help with your skin, there are links for all of my coaching offerings, for the workbook, for everything down in the description box. There's also a link for Skinessa down in the description box. It's the by far the best probiotic for skin health. Remember to subscribe, remember to share, remember to hit your notification bell, bing, and leave your comments and questions down below. Much love, I'll be back with many more videos really soon. Peace.